Hi everyone, welcome back to Beyond the Studio Pilates. My name's Hannah and today I want to take you through a nice session for back mobility and strength. This is a really great session for if you suffer from a little bit of back pain. This is just going to help to mobilize and strengthen up your muscles to support and sustain a really healthy back. I hope you find it really beneficial. We're going to start sitting down and we're going to start either with crossed legs or you can sit in diamond, so out like this. And then from here, you're just going to sit up nice and tall, thinking about your sit bones being in contact with the ground, core engaged, ribs in line with your hips, chin lifted, so make sure you're not looking down or kind of craning your neck. Think about where your ears should be, just over your collarbone. Then from here, we're just going to take your ear to the right-hand side and then just going to roll your head forward and round to the left, and then we're going to roll back to the right. So you're just rolling that head from one side to the other, just nice gentle neck roll. Keep sitting up nice and tall. And then you're going to bring your head back to the middle, chin to chest, and then we're going to go up. So you're sitting up nice and tall again, and then you're just going to take your head to the ceiling. Just let your jaw relax down, and then back to the middle, and then we're going to go chin to chest. Back to the middle, up, back to the middle, chin to chest. Going to do four more like that. And final two. Okay, so final chin to chest and then bringing your head into the middle. Then from here, you're just going to lift and lower through each shoulder. So you can bring your hands out to the sides if you want to. Just lifting and lowering through those shoulders. So it's really important when we are going to be mobilizing through our back that we do some nice warming up of that back first. Just getting it moving a little bit. Okay. Then from here, we're going to come into our cat stretch. So again, keeping yourself in sitting, you're just going to roll yourself forward into your cat stretch. So moving your weight onto your knees, bringing yourself forward so that you're into your cat stretch position, so into your box position. Wrist is under your shoulder, knee is under your hip, tilting that pelvis so your tailbone is pointing off towards the back wall. Holding here for an inhale. Then you're going to exhale. Take your head between your hands and arch your back into the ceiling. Holding it here for an inhale. And then exhale, taking it back through, sliding those shoulder blades down your back, hold for an inhale. And then exhale, back up, arching that back, hold for an inhale. And then exhale, taking it in the other direction. So you're taking your spine through a large range of movement here, so we need to keep it nice and controlled. Going to do two more here. So final cat stretch. So this time you're coming back into the middle. And then from here, you're going to bring yourself back. So you're sitting onto your knees. Now, if it's not comfortable to sit on your knees, you can just find your way back to sitting cross-legged instead. So you're coming to sitting on your knees or sitting cross-legged, core engage. Think about drawing yourself up towards the ceiling, making yourself taller. You're going to bring your hands to your shoulders, bring your elbows so they're roughly in line with your shoulders. And then from here, we're going to rotate and come back to the center. So you're just rotating through that mid spine. So your thoracic spine is doing the moving, everything else stays nice and still. Think about inhaling through your nose, exhaling through your mouth. Nice gentle spine twist to each side. Okay, this time I'm going to add on a little bit more movement. So we're going to turn to the side, and then you're going to drop your right shoulder, bring your left shoulder up, come back to the side, and then back to the middle. So we're going to go left shoulder back and lower, and then back up and back to the top. If you want to, you can take your arms out. So you're going to come around and back, back up and to the middle, round and back, back up and to the middle. Three more. Thinking belly button to spine, core engaged, pelvic floor on. If you need to, just reduce the movement by bringing your arms back in so you've made the movement a little bit smaller. This is the final one to each side. Okay, then from here we're coming back into our four-point kneeling position. So we're going to work into that upper back a little bit more. So thinking about your position, remember knees under your hips, hands under your shoulders. If you need to, remember you can create a fist. Then from here, core engaged, pelvic floor on, eye line down. Just going to bring your right arm up so it's next to your body, and then you're going to bend that arm, create a fist, and then take your elbow higher. So take your elbow as high as you can. Then from here, we're going to extend that arm out and bring it back in. Extend that arm out, bring it back in. Now you could add a little hand weight to this if you wanted to, just to increase that resistance. We're going to do four more here. And final two. And final one. Okay, then hold it there, keep that elbow high, and then you're just going to do a little pulse higher. So you're just pushing that elbow just as high as you can without feeling like you're turning through your body, so everything else stays nice and still. Just a little pulse, eye line stays down at the floor, so your head is still in its neutral alignment. Final three, two, one, and then bring that arm back down. I'm going to do the other side now. Core engaged, pelvic floor on, sweep that arm backwards, bend that arm, create a fist, take your elbow as high as you feel comfortable, and then just gently extending through that arm. So as you extend through that arm, you're not locking out through the elbow, you're keeping the elbow soft, but you're just extending that arm out as far as you can without locking onto that elbow. Core engaged, pelvic floor on. I'm going to do three more here. Two and final one. Okay, then bring that elbow up and then little pulses. So try and keep your arm next to your body as you pulse. It's almost like you're pulling something off the ground with that hand. And final three, two, one, and then bring that arm back down. From here, we're going to come onto our fronts and onto some swan dive. So swan dive again is really good for that upper back, and we're going to take our back into extension. So we do a lot of things that bring us forward in real life, typing, picking up things off the floor, driving the car. So what I want you to do is really think about opening up through that chest and using those upper back muscles so that they pull back your shoulders and make you broader, but in a good way. So we're going to come down onto our fronts. First thing you need to think about is tucking those toes in so your glutes are off. Getting nice and comfortable, core engaged, so you're not pushing your belly into the floor. You're going to bring your arms out into your swan dive position. So your elbow is in front of your shoulder and your eye line remains down at the floor. If you want to, you can have something under your forehead, but you don't have to if you don't want to. Drawing those shoulder blades down your back, so make sure they're not starting up near your ears. We're going to take an inhale here. Then we're going to exhale, and you're going to gently lift your head, neck and shoulders off the mat. So the work is coming through that upper back. There should be no tension in that lower back, and you're not pushing down on your hands, so you shouldn't feel like all the weight is in your arms. That's why your elbow is in front of your shoulder. You're going to hold it at the top here for an inhale. And then exhale. Slowly, with control, bring yourself back down to the mat. Core engaged, pelvic floor, and inhaling at the bottom. Exhale, back up, holding it there, sliding those shoulder blades down your back, hold. And then exhale, back to the floor. We're going to do three more like this. So holding at the bottom for an inhale. Exhale, lifting, sliding those shoulder blades down your back. Remember, keep your neck nice and long, hold. And exhale, back to the mat. Final two here, core engaged. Holding at the top. And then exhale, back down to the mat. Okay, so we're now going to add in a leg and take our swan dive up a little bit higher, so more into like a cobra. If this isn't quite right for you, any discomfort on that lower back, just go back to what we've been doing. And if you find it's just a little bit tricky today, just doesn't feel right, then again, just go back to what we've just been doing instead. So for your higher cobra, you're going to bring your arms back, so your elbows now more in line with your shoulders. You're still not pushing down on your arms, but you're going to need to think about peeling your arms off, starting with your elbow. So you are using your arms a little bit more in this one. So holding at the bottom for an inhale. Exhale, use that upper back, and then gently start to peel your elbows off the floor and just come to where you feel comfortable. So you might be all the way up here, or you might be a little bit lower. Just have it where you feel comfy. Then what we're going to do is, as you go down, you're going to lift your right leg off the floor, stretch out through that leg, hold at the bottom for an inhale, and then exhale, slowly bring yourself back up and lower that leg back down. Now we're going to go and lift the left leg, so holding at the top for an inhale, exhale, lift and stretch out through that left leg, holding at the bottom for another inhale, and exhale, head, neck and shoulders come off, gently bringing yourself up, holding at the top for an inhale, exhale, slowly, with control, bringing yourself back down to the mat, lifting that leg up, hold for an inhale, exhale, head, neck and shoulders off the mat, leg back down, hold for an inhale, exhale, gently back to the floor, hold at the bottom for an inhale, and exhale, back up. So we're going to do two more on each leg, so holding at the top for an inhale, and exhale, gently back to the ground, hold, exhale, keep thinking belly button to spine, core engaged, pelvic floor on, keeping the movement nice and fluid, so you're just almost rocking, but in a gentle, controlled way, really stretching out through that leg. So final one on each side now, and final one. So this time, as you lower, you're going to leave your legs on the floor, hands under your shoulders, push yourself back, and we're going to come into a wide knee child's pose. So just really sitting down in between your knees. This is really lovely just to stretch out through your back and hips. So we're going to hold it here for 30 seconds, but you could hold it for a bit longer if you wanted to. thanks for joining my back care special. I hope you really enjoyed it. Take care, and I'll see you on a mat again very soon. Bye for now.